Hi guys, just thought I'd show you this little building I've been working on. This is as far as I'm going to go on it. I'm not going to do no more. I was going to do interior. It's actually a workshop on this half and blacksmiths on this half. I was going to put blacksmith detail inside plus a couple of two stables. In this workshop was going to be the office. Obviously here was a door and a few windows. Just to show you the skill of this thing. This is what you would call 54 mil for toy soldiers or model farming, 132 scale, whatever. But it's all hand thatched. I will do vids on how to do this. Just for now, I just thought to show you this little model of mine. This is as far as I'm going to go on it. Here you've got double doors I would open at. Office door you can have it open or closed, whichever, but this is actually the workshop. I was going to cut a hole in here and put a sunken floor, you know, pit basically, so you can put vehicles inside. Roof does lift off if I get it. It's a bit awkward this here. There we go. So it's all ready to be done inside. That's just a shape of what the roof looks like. So it's just quick and simple. You got to take this one off first before you can get this off. This is all hand thatched. So as you can see, it is pretty heavy. I've actually used flax or hemp from the flax plant, so it is quite a hefty bit of kit. Of course, as you can see, this is all the detail inside. There's nothing much inside. It's just all ready for walls to be put in and more detail to go inside, but I'm not going to do that. I'm basically getting rid of this model. I've had it for such a long time. So I'm going to put it all back together. Now there's a little cut out here because when I made this, it was going to be a slate roof, but then I thought, oh, stuff it. I'll just put in a corrugated one. Why not? And that's it there. All fits in. Ready to go. Oh, yeah. And these hinges on here and the bolts do work. Okay. So that's the top half of your stable. Now down here I've got a kick bar, so you flick it up, whichever way it is. Oops, you're stuck, that's where. It locks that way so you can pull back your bolt and you won't open because you've got a kick bar on. You've got a little thing on there, you put your foot on it and flick it over and she stops a little stopper there and bottom door open. There you go. These doors do come off. And get one tester. That's it. See, it all comes off. So you can put on, you know, separate doors to show what they are. So you can get a close up on this one. There's a little kick bar. It does move. It's a bit stiff like because of the paint work on it. You can see, bolt does work perfectly. Okay. Looks a bit chunky like, but these are prop hinges I made. Not very easy. These are made out of brass, I think, or metal or tin or whatever I used. Same as this one. So there's a little bolt. Okay, and that's it. Just thought I'd show you my 54mm get in focus. Come on. There we go. Ooh, not lovely. You can see it, but that's better. That's it. Just a quick view rod. There is a window inside here. It's got mesh on it because that's where the stables were going to go at the back of this half. Tack room in here. Blacksmith, of course, was going to go in there. And then the rest of it is just all the workshop. All right, there you go. All this brickwork is all hand done. Took me hours to get this. It took two of us to do this because my hands just broke off me. All the drains are fitted in and the gutters, all done by hand. Well, that's it. Well, thanks for watching. If you want something made, just give us a shout. Cheers. Bye.